To enable material designers, go to plugins and search for material designer and enable it. After that, click on window tab and go to material designer, click on it, and you will get this material designer window. You have new material, PBR, continue. After that, go to base color, and here we need to add layers and make sure our inputs are solid color. You can do a texture if you want. In this use case, I'm just going to use solid colors. Let's add one more layer and one more. First layer will have to be red. Do keep in mind this will compile shaders frequently. First layer will be red, second layer will be yellow, third layer will be black, just in case. Now, for the textures, we are going to use these textures as alpha masks, and I don't have a texture prepared for this specifically, but I will be using Unreal texture from the starter kit, a random one, which is like used for mannequin, and I'm going to use grid checker texture, which is gives us a nice outline of the texture. Now we are going to add an effect which is called distort spin. Effects are modifiers you can add to each layer, and some effects are specific to color or UV, and some of them are just general stuff that can affect texture or overall motion or tiling, etc. of the material. In this case, we are going to just add spin and swirl. Spin UV distortion just spins your texture, swirl bends it in a swirl way, as you will see in screen soon. And we are going to only do it for the first two layers because we don't want to touch the third layer. Third layer is just a black material, just in case the textures don't fit what I want. We don't want it to have some void or empty space. Now, let's go and enlarge the tile of the texture. Because we use grid checker to outline the corners, with swirl we see how material is being bended, which gives us these nice yellow outlines. And if we go to the first layer and up the tiling by 8, you will get this material, which is like all swirly. Obviously, this is not the ideal material for it. And let's make sure we tile it properly. Yes, this is not the ideal texture for it, but this is just a demonstration of what you can do with any texture, really. Just find the texture you want or create it from scratch and apply it. Now, we have this material, but we don't have it as an asset. This is in the memory, but it's not part of the asset. You cannot find it in Content Browser. To do this, you can click on the icon on top right and click New Generate Material. This general material is essentially the exact same material we were using previously before Material Designer existed. You can apply it, just use it in any other material, and as you can see, you can do any modifications you want here. And it is stored as an asset, and you can check your content drawer to see it. But if you click on New Material Instance, it will not show up, because now we export it as a general material. To create an instance of it, first we need to export Material Designer material, which is this one. And we can now apply it to anything, or if you can click on the New Material Instance, and now we have an instance of this material applied. This new instance, which is applied in the level, again, does not have a version of it in your content browser. It is just stored in the memory of the level. But you can modify its color, properties, effects, anything you want individually. If you try to export Material Design material, it will give you an error warning that it already exists, which is fair. You could still do it, but there is no real reason to. And if you right click on the Material Designer material and create instance, we now have two instances of this material. And we can use the second one, which actually has an asset in your content browser, and modify it, that one. You will notice the new material instance we created, if we modify it, all other actors with the same material instance get modified as well. But the initial new material instance, the purple one we created, did not have that. It doesn't have an asset file, so we are forced to individually edit it, which may not be ideal. You may want an actual material instance to edit this specific actor. And for that, what we need to do is a bit different. If you go and try to, again, as I said previously, create a material designer material, this will, again, just create a new material design material, and it's not really an instance. So what you may try to do is instead go to the content drawer and create a new material instance. Not of the general material, but the material distance material. If you try to do it with the master material, do keep in mind there is a bug in the Unreal plugin at the moment, which is understandable. It's an experimental plugin. There will be an issue, which I will demonstrate now. First, let's create a material instance. Now we have the second instance, we can modify any way we want. And it can be edited without touching other instances. And it has an asset file, so we can always just click on the asset and do it. But if you duplicate it and modify it and apply this modified new duplicated instance, it will not work. I believe it to be a bug, which is understandable, it's in experimental stage. But make sure you don't duplicate the instance itself. What you need to do instead is you click on the material designer material, right click on it, and create an instance of material designer material. Name it whatever you want, apply it, and modify it now. This way, you are sure to have a complete control with new material design material plugin, which and an asset in your content browser that you can edit regardless of the level, and you can reuse it. If you enjoy our tutorials, we would gladly appreciate your subscription and likes. Visit 3D College to learn more. I'll see you in the next tutorial.